Hello, Mr. Mayor. Are you the mayor of the city or anything here?
Listen, I think you know me, Mr. Mayor.
Howard. I have a little message here that I need to read. And let me just start with it here. I know it's in my council district and in here, neither is Cris Medina, who's in District 7. This is the letter that we just delivered to Susan Reed. It says, Dear District Attorney Reed, on October 12th, my wife and I were awakened to receive a letter of a threatening phone call at 3:01 a.m. This call stated that I've been warned to leave the city councilman, Diego Bernal, alone. I've also had threats made over the internet. San Antonio Police Officer Soto, badge number 9739, created case number SAPD 11261976 concerning the phone and internet threats. Now I'm reading this for a person that's sitting outside. Because of several instances in the past, I'm certain that the San Antonio Police Department, and especially Chief William McManus, have no interest in investigating the case. Of these incidences involved several armed SAPD officers dispatched to my home at 10 p.m. on July 4, 2011 for a psychiatric evaluation. There has never been any reports of any type involving law violations, disturbances, or threats by myself and or family. When asked who or what had prompted this investigation, no reasons or names were given. The police report filed on this incident clearly shows there were no grounds for this investigation. Police Chief McManus and City Attorney Regard have also issued a criminal trespass warning prohibiting me from entering City Hall, City Council meetings, City offices, etc. This is a clear violation of the Texas Open Meetings Act. When asked repeatedly why this warning was in place, no written or verbal explanation has ever been given. I am publicly asking that your office request an investigation by Texas Rangers on this matter. As required by Texas law, a request of investigation must come from a law enforcement agency. Because of their actions and or inactions, the obligation now falls on your office. Signed by a gentleman named John E. Fondle. Mr. Fondle has been trying to get people from the city to do this. Excuse me one second. I have somebody looking at an extra 3 minutes.
Who's that?
Ms. Fondle.
All right, thank you. Go ahead.
That Mr. Fondle has been trying to expose accounting issues for the past 5 years since his dismissal of the false allegations. He has been repeatedly told no. He has been kicked out of police offices by the police chief. And it's time for something to be done. Something needs to be investigating the Facebook activities of Mr. Diego Bernal. And we want this to stop. When something goes over the internet and becomes from out of the country, that becomes a federal offense. We expect that to be taken care of by the appropriate officers, which we tried to do here. He has never received any contact or anything else involving any of this. I would like to know and ask the city to give Mr. Fondle a reason why he is not allowed to be in this building. By the acts of the city attorney and the San Antonio police chief, it is clear that they're trying to stop Mr. Fondle from asking questions, which he's entitled to as a citizen of the United States. Never been convicted of a crime, never had any issues to go. Therefore, it needs to be taken care of. Mr. Medina has been aware of this. He knows that I asked him. I've given him 2 weeks for any type of answer, which I haven't gotten. That is why I'm here. Also, to let you know that since you do know that this is going on, I suggest, according to you all knowing that how the rules rules of the city charter are, including ethics involvement. Once you know that there's a crime being committed, you're duly